Good morning, everybody. Amen. Amen. Come on and stand on your feet and give God what is due this morning. If you could just open up your mouth with thanksgiving. Come on now. I shouldn't have to be able to teach. I'm talking about Jesus. We're here because he's here. I know that God gave his only begotten, and the one way I always like to give myself a gift unto God, I like to sing unto him. So if you can help me, we're gonna do as normal before we go into our festives this morning. Is that all right? I give myself away. Oh, I give myself away so you can. That's why we're here. Say it again. Yeah. I love you, Lord. So you. One more time. Say it again. I give myself. Yeah. That's how you do it. Love you in the house, oh God. This is your house. Verse 8, say, here I am. Here I stand. Lord, my life is in your hands. Lord, I long. I'm longing. Longing to see your desires revealed in me. Everybody say,
give myself away.
Yeah. Come on and give a gift to the Lord. Come on, open your mouth and open and give him your heart. Give him your life. Say it again. Give myself. Oh. Father, we thank you. We magnify you. You're an awesome God. We bless you because you're God and you've been good throughout the whole entire year. No matter what we've been through, you've still been God and you've been good. And you sit high and you look low. This is the time that we celebrate your birth, and we thank you, God, for living down on the inside of us. God, you're an awesome God and you're a mighty God, and we come in here today to give you reverence, not just to look at trees and look at lights, but we come to lift up the name of the Most High God. Your name is Jesus. First Noel, God, we thank you, we magnify you. So God, as we lift our hands and we extol you today, God, we thank you because whatever we do today, God, we give it unto you. Let us minister unto you, O God, that you would minister through us. And your people will be lifted and draw nigh unto you as you draw nigh unto us. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah is bragging on your God in the name of Jesus.
Every morning. He rules the world.
Got a reason to celebrate, don't we? Hallelujah. We serve a risen Lord, a risen King, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. I don't know if you've thought about the awesomeness, if I can use that word, of the Christmas story. For the Lord, for God above, the God of heaven and earth, to give up his only begotten Son for you and for me. We got the better part of that trade-off. Amen. We got the better part of that trade-off. And then for Jesus to give his own life for you and for me and to trade out righteousness for sin. And for all of that to have been mapped out, planned out from the beginning of time. From before time began, isn't that awesome? Listen, because he did that knowing not only what kind of sinner you were, but he did that also knowing what kind of Christian you would be. And he still decided to go through with it? Man, somebody must love you. Somebody must love me, amen. He's a good God today. Can we take some needs to him in prayer this morning? If you have a need in the house, would you just lift up your hand and say, Pastor Philip, yes, I've got a need. I'd like the church to help me pray. We're so thankful you've come our way today at Word of Life on behalf of our senior pastor, Bishop, and his wife, Jeannie, and all the staff pastors, the good people here at Word of Life. We're so thankful you've come our way today. We pray God blesses you. Amen. Amen. Let's pray together. Father, we worship you this morning. And I give you praise because you're God. Lord, I thank you for giving your Son. God, I thank you for giving your Son. And Lord, I thank you, Jesus, for giving your life. That you would do that for us. You must love us. You must love us. You must love us. Thank you, God, for your great love, your great grace, your great mercy. Thank you, Lord. God, we lift up needs in the house to you this morning. God, we do that in faith today because we've seen you do the miraculous around here. God, we've seen you save. We've seen you heal. We have seen you deliver and set free. We've seen you provide in miraculous ways. And so, Lord, we lift up these needs today in faith, God. We're not praying in doubt today. We are praying in faith this morning, believing y'all, God. Hallelujah. Believing that you not only can do it, but that you will do it. Hallelujah. Because you're a good God. Because you love us. God, save, heal, deliver, set free. Do only the work that only you can do this morning. We give you the praise, the glory, and the honor because you deserve it all. It all belongs to you. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. God bless you this morning.
Amen. Somebody give God a shout of praise. Yeah. Thank you, Pastor Philip. Turn around to one or two or three people and tell them Merry Christmas. I'm glad you're here. Don't say happy holidays, Merry Christmas. Merry, Merry Christmas. You can be seated after you've made a few people merry. Hallelujah. Well, can you believe we're just about 4 days away from Christmas 2014? Seemed like just a week or two ago I was announcing that it was 90 days till Christmas. And now it's already upon us. And we were talking, I won't tell who was talking before service, but one of the ushers who kind of heads up the ushers and has the same last name as mine was talking about going out on to Woodruff Road yesterday. I said, there's a man of faith. A man who needs prayer, probably needs to be saved today, but he needs faith. I mean, he has faith. No, but anyway, Christmas is about Jesus. It's about showing the love of Jesus, and it's about sharing the love of Jesus, and we don't want to lose that in all of the commercializing and everything else going on. But by the same token, we want to celebrate, and we want the world to know we can celebrate. You know, too many Christians think serving the Lord is being glum and you know, just serious all the time and not having a good time. I think Christians ought to have a better time than anybody else in the world, because we know what our outcome's going to be. Amen. We know it's the best is yet to come, and so we're gonna just welcome all of our visitors. Again, Pastor Philip and Melissa. We were out in the earlier service with them. They do the 9 o'clock and do such a wonderful job. We were out with them this morning for a little bit, and then appreciate him and with him and all the pastors. We welcome you to Word of Life family. Now Tuesday night we're going to have our family service, and I really don't think you want to miss it. It's going to be a candlelight type service with the trees. We're going to have Christmas carols and communion, and starting at 7 o'clock, we're going to start a little later Wednesday night. We're going to have from 7 to 7:30. We're going to be giving away coffee and hot chocolate and have a time of fellowship out in the foyer, and then we're going to come in and have just our family Christmas service Tuesday night instead of Wednesday night. So I want to invite you to come, bring somebody with you. We'd like to see God do. I know a lot of people. Pastor Philip was talking about this year, the people who've been healed and touched, and God just did an awesome miracle for my wife and I this week, and some things going on. And we just thank God for that. And I've seen so many people healed and touched through the communion service. So if you can come out Tuesday night and be with us, it'll be just a good time to get together for our WOL family Christmas service before you get with the rest of your family. But anyway, we just want to let you know we're glad to have you. Well, ask ushers to come on up and get ready to receive. Now, what we like to do here, we like to receive. Oh, visitor packets, I'm sorry. Do we have any first-time visitors in the house? If you'll hold your hand up, we want to give you a visitor packet. Come on, WOL folks, let them know. So thankful that you're with us today. Thank you, Mike. When you get over 30, sometimes you forget things a little easier. Anyway, now we'll ask the ushers to come on up and get ready to receive your offer. Go ahead and stand up on your feet with us if you would, please. We like to bring our offerings and offer it to the Lord, then just kind of take some time to greet one another and get to know some of the greatest people in the world standing in this room this morning. Amen. You believe that? Talking about you. So let's do that. Hold your offering up. This is my offering. I give it to God. And I know I can't outgive God. Happy birthday, Jesus. Amen. Bring your offerings and then love on some folk in the house this morning. Thank you.
If you'll indulge me for a moment, I would like to give a Christmas gift to my mother.
Holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining. Till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious light. Fall on your knees, or hear the angel voices, for night divine, oh night, when Christ was born, oh night divine. Gospel is peace.
Shall he pray?
And in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise, we let all within us praise his holy name. Fall on your knees, for hear the angel voices, O night divine, O night, when Christ was born, O night divine.
Our theme for this year is Come Home for Christmas. Whoop. That comes later. Sorry. Our theme this year is Come Home for Christmas. So we have set up the living room, and we want to invite you to come home with us and spend a little bit of time together. And so instead of preparing a lot of stuff to perform for you, we want to ask you to sing with us. So if you would start, we're going to do some traditional Christmas carols together, and we want you to sing with us, okay? And I'm going to tell you, We tried to go over a little bit of this, and they need your help with the words. So sing loud.
Just on frosty.
This is literally just like sitting around in the living room. You know, at Christmas time, if you're from a musical family like we are, this is what we do at Christmas time. We sit down at the piano, and everybody just kind of gathers around, and somebody calls out a song, and we try it. Sometimes we get it, and sometimes we don't. So we didn't practice some of these a lot, and I did that on purpose, because if we don't get them, hopefully you'll get them for us. Not all will be that. We did practice some stuff. But some of these you will know, hopefully better than we will. And so we're going to start with Jingle Bells, because I think everybody knows that. So let's sing together.
Dashing through the snow in one horse open sleigh, o'er the fields we go, laughing all the way.
I hear them do it. Just them, okay? Go. Yeah. Does anybody know the second verse? Sing it. Everybody sing. Better watch out, you better not cry.
You better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
He's making a list.
He's checking it twice. Gonna find out who's naughty or nice. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Let them do this part. Sound great. All right, Frosty.
Oh my.
Let's try it. This has been interesting. Help, please. You gonna help? Okay.
Frosty the snowman, go.
Blah, 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 blah.
One day,
there must have been some magic
in that old silk hat head down. The wind that placed it on his head, he began to dance around. Frosty the snowman, hurry home that day. When you wave goodbye, say don't you cry, I'll be back again someday.
Now, I tell you, that's just like being at home. All right.
I know.
What?
White Christmas.
I think we all know that one. Okay.
Oh,
favorite Christmas carol is Mary, Did You Know? And Jeannie, would you mind singing that for us? I'd love to hear it.
All right, all right. You have a mic?
I have my mic.
All right.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. Mary, did you know?
favorite things to do at Christmas time is to go to Christmas concerts. You guys do that besides today? One of our favorite Christmas concerts is the Trans-Siberian Orchestra. Has anybody been there? Well, I wanted to bring them here today. I tried, but they were a little bit too much to get in the living room, so we did our own version of that. So I want to ask Matt. Yeah. If he will play Carol of the Bells for us today. Who needs the Trans-Siberian Orchestra? They're just a bunch of lights. All right. Well, another thing that's a favorite to do at Christmas time is to watch Christmas movies. And there's the classics, and there's the new ones, and there's the Disney ones. But I think probably, has anybody here not seen Frozen? You've not seen Frozen? I didn't think anybody on the planet had not seen Frozen. Can anybody in this room not sing Let It Go? Well, you can sing it along with us this morning because we have Elsa here. And we're going to watch a Christmas movie together. So while we're sitting around in the living room for Christmas this year, let's watch Frozen together. Can you roll the movie for us?
The snow glows white on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know. Well, now they know. Let it go, let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. Let it go, let it go. Turn away. Never bothered me anyway. It's funny how some distance makes everything seem small, and the fears that once controlled me can't get to me at all. It's time to see what I can do to test the limits and break through. No right, no wrong, no rules for me. I'm free. Let it go, let it go. I'm one with the wind and sky. Let it go, let it go. Flurries through the air into the ground. My soul is spiraling in frozen fractals all around. And one thought crystallizes like an icy blast. I'm never going back. The past is in the past.
Let it go.
I'll rise like the break of dawn.
Let it go, let it go.
That perfect girl is gone.
Here I stand in the light of day.
Let the storm rage on. Cold never bothered me anyway.
Yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Yourself a merry little Christmas. Make a Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away.
if the Lord bring us
this time of year. It's all about children and celebrating and the lights and the tinsel and giving thanks and coming together as family and friends and loved ones. But what about the child? The greatest gift. That's what is the main thing. Enjoy. Children are wishing and dreaming for presents under the tree. Candlelights are all aglow. The chill of winter is in the air. Songs of Christmas past and new. Bells are ringing through and through. The words we whisper and love to hear are saying I love you. But what about the child who was born just to die? And precious gift to us from on high. And what about the babe whose future was the cross, to die to save the world from sin, so our souls would not be lost? Shopping and spreading cheer to everyone you meet. The joy of friends both far and near is food for all to eat. As families gather together, there's laughter everywhere. Oh, how nice it is to see each one and show them just how much you care. But what about the child in swaddling clothes he lay? Meek and humble, precious lamb in a manger. Someday we'd all be free, free from burden, sin, and shame. This child has come to set us free. His name is Jesus.
this child is come that all might see that Jesus is His name. For to us a child is born, and star shines in one starry sky, while shepherds watch their flocks by night. An angel lifts his voice, go find your Savior Christ the Lord. Shepherds walk
child. He's a magnificent Savior. Amen. Come on, stand to your feet. We're going to worship the Lord for a moment before the word is brought forward. This is what the angel sang when he was born.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Jesus. Lord, we celebrate who you are. Right now we sing hallelujah. Oh, we love you, Jesus. You're the greatest gift of all. Yes, you are. A precious baby born in a manger. Come on, let's just lift our voice, say hallelujah. Jesus, we magnify you, Lord. Say hallelujah. We love you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Lord, we lift our voice in praise. We worship you, Lord. Because you are worthy. Hey. Now Christ is born in Bethlehem. Come on and give him praise this morning. Hallelujah. Christ was born.
Hallelujah.
He's a mighty God. Yeah. Lord, we say hallelujah to you today.
Come on,
hallelujah to the Lamb of God.
Give him a
thank you, Jesus. You're worthy, Lord. Yes, you are.
Woo.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, let the choir know how much you appreciate what they did this morning. Amen. Thank you, Mike. You can be seated for just a minute, and then we're going to get into some snow in just a second. Thank you, choir. But I just wanted to bring a reminder before we start the snow and everything else. Again, thank you so much for being here with our celebration. Last week, I talked about Luke chapter 2, and I want to go back to that just briefly. Behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them. The glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were greatly afraid. And the angel said, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people." How many all people do we have in the house today? "For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You'll find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and rags, basically, lying in a feed trough, a manger. Suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, on earth peace, goodwill toward men." And last week I shared with the church, probably, that's been 2,000 years ago about, and probably for the last 2,000 years, I don't know there's ever been a time when there was total peace on earth. And over that Jesus, the name Jesus, there's probably been more wars fought and more blood shed than maybe any other individual in the history of the world. And so I told them last week, I asked the Lord, why would you promise peace on earth? Why would the angels say, glory to God in the highest, on earth peace, goodwill toward men? Why would they say, we bring you good tidings of great joy, and we've not seen peace, really? We've not seen the joy. A lot of people don't experience the joy. A lot of people don't experience the good news. And God said, I've offered the gift. It's up to you to receive the gift. Jesus, 2,000 years ago, came to the earth, the gift that was offered for mankind. And it's a lot like, you know, I don't know if you've ever given anybody a gift, a Christmas gift or a birthday gift, but I hate to give somebody something and they don't appreciate it. They don't use it. You don't ever see them use it or whatever. I like when I give somebody a gift, I like to know they're going to use it, they're going to appreciate it. And so we see that God offered the gift of Jesus. And what a lot of people say, well, you know, if God is such a great God, if God's such a loving God and a good God, why all the problems? Why are there starving children? Why are there hurting people? Why is this? Why is that? And the simple fact is, not everybody has received the gift. He's offered it, but he's not received. It's much like I heard a story several years ago about a woman who was living in poverty, and someone was touched, their heart was touched for this woman, and they felt sorry for her, so they wrote her out a check for $100,000 and gave it to her, but they didn't explain what it was. Several weeks later, they came and found the woman. She had frozen to death, was starving, and they went and looked, and she had taken the beautiful check somebody had written her and framed it and put it on the wall, not knowing what it was. Here was the answer to all her problems, but she didn't recognize the gift that was given to her. And I just want to tell you what's wrong with the world today is God has offered the answer to all of our problems, but we haven't received the gift that he's offered. See, our life is a result of our choices. Deuteronomy 30 and 19, he said, I call heaven and earth to witness today against you that I've set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore, choose life that both you and your descendants are lived. Your life is a result of the choices that you make. God will not make you do anything. And so our life is a result of our choices, whether we choose to receive the gift of peace and love and joy, or whether we choose to just go our own way and do our own thing. Our life is a result of our choices, but God offers the gift. The angel said in verse 10, Luke 2 and 10, the angel said, do not be afraid. Behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people, for there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord. Jesus came to be that great gift. As a matter of fact, John 10:10 says, the thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy, but I've come that you may have life and have it more abundantly. This morning, I want to tell you, God has offered you the gift of a good life. He's offered you the gift. He said, my plans for you are the plans to bless you and to prosper you and to give you a future. That's the gift he offers, but the question is, are you willing to do whatever it takes to receive the gift that he's offered you? Because I told him last week, a gift actually has two points. It has the giver and it has the receiver. And a gift is never completely a gift until the receiver receives what the giver has offered. And so that's what I want to encourage us to do today. We must receive the gift. We have to receive the gift. John 1 and 10 said, he was in the world, and the world was made through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own did not receive him. But as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become the children of God, to those who believe in his name. Verse 13 said, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of flesh, but of the will of God, but of God. He said he's offered the gift, but until we receive the gift, he's offered you the gift of life. He's offered you the gift of peace and of joy and of love. But until you receive the gift, till you swallow your pride and you quit trying to do it your own way and say, you know what, God, I'm ready to do it your way and not my way. Till I receive the gift, I can't fully have the gift. So this morning, Christmas, coming up on Christmas 2014, this is December 21st, 2014, I want to encourage everybody in this room, everybody listening to me this morning, I want to encourage you to say, you know what, Lord, I've decided to receive the peace that you've offered in my life. I've decided to receive the joy that you've offered for me in my life. I can't depend on anybody else to give me peace, to give me joy. I can't depend on it. I've decided to receive the gift of love that you've offered in my life. You've been standing there with your hand out offering me this gift all this time. You know what? Today, I'm going to receive the gift that you've offered. Amen? Go ahead and stand up on your feet. See, that's the shortest sermon you're going to hear me preach. Because I believe God's already working in some hearts. Go ahead, guys, and get ready to go to the next phase of service. Here's what I want you to do. I want you to bow your head and close your eyes with me in this room this morning. Because I believe God has just has ordained this service, ordained this time for us to come together. I believe it's God's will for us to come in this place this morning. And I believe he's speaking to some hearts to tell us, you know what I want you to do? I want you to receive the gift. I stand at the door and knock. I stand offering you the gift of peace. This morning, if you're going through a time in your life when you need peace, I want somebody to just slip up here and say, you know what, God, I receive your peace this morning into my life. I receive your peace into my home. I receive your peace into my heart. I receive your peace into my mind. Maybe it's joy. Maybe the enemy's just tried to destroy your joy and steal your joy. Jesus said, I come to give it back. I receive your joy into my life this morning, Lord. I'm going to be happy. It's not going to be what somebody gives me or does for me. The joy is going to be from the inside out. The peace is going to come from the inside out. I receive your peace. I receive your love into my life today, God. The gift of love. I receive the gift of salvation into my life today. I receive it in your life. Can we all pray this prayer together? Will you pray this with me? My Father in heaven, I need you in my life. I need your joy. I need your peace. I need your love. Today, I receive your gift of life. I accept Jesus as a gift to me, and I give you myself a gift to you. In Jesus' name. If you believe that, come on, give God a praise in this house. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you prayed that prayer for the first time, we want to hear from you. Tell one of the pastors or email us or whatever and let us know. But God bless you. I pray this will be the greatest Christmas season you've ever had. Now, I'm going to get out of the way because there's somebody else the kids are really excited about seeing. And we always like to conclude this Christmas time. And what we're going to do, we'll let all the kids that want to come down front and get in the snow, you come on ahead and get in the snow. And I guess, Pastor David, I'll turn it over to you. Somebody give God one more praise.
Snow glows white on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to
Kids,
be.
Frosty's in the back of the room.
Don't feel, don't let them know.
And I see the Grinch.
Well, now they
And
know.
I see Santa Claus.
Let it go, let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. Let it go, let it go. Turn away and slam the door.
I don't care what they're going to say.
Let the storm rage on. Cold never bothered me anyway. It's funny how some distance makes everything seem small, and the fears that once controlled me can't get to me